This is the new government, obviously, so we would want to give them space to do things correctly. In our case, South Africa, we do auditing all the time. It doesn't stop and start. It's a continuous process because we want to ensure that from time to time, we've got the environment protected. You do have pockets of illegal mining, those who are artisanal mining, who don't have proper license condition that obliges them to do certain things. The way we deal with that, we go and assess them. So we do have some control over it, although illegal mining is still a problem all over the world, including South Africa. So it's a continuous challenge, but in terms of the established miners, we are satisfied that they know what to do, they know the rules of the game, they are very clear in terms of certainty and the direction that we are going as a country.
And before you go, I know you've South Africa's got a stake in some of the companies we have here. We have Lepanto and Goldfields. How are they doing so far?
I've got all the confidence that Lepanto and Goldfields will do us proud, because Goldfields is one of the established gold companies in South Africa, and they've got all the knowledge, the experience, and the expertise to do proper, responsible mining. Our experience is that investors just want certainty. You put the rules of the game, they comply. In our case, for instance, we'd say we give you a license for 30 years, and it's renewable. In that 30 years, if you behave, the environment is protected, the workers are protected, the workers, etc. Because we employ just under 500,000 people in the mining industry, sort of directly now. Indirectly, it can be double or even more. So we know that employment is part of the critical economic spinners in any situation, in any city, and in any country.
So it's safe to say the South African stake in these companies will stay?
Yeah, they
in
will
Lepanto
stay.
And Goldfields?
No, they stay. Well, they are very resilient. Miners are very resilient. They stay under difficult odds because their job is really to navigate difficult circumstances and conditions. So the Chamber of Mines here, I'm satisfied that they will do their best to do your government proud, the people of the Philippines proud, and so on. And also the government. Our case is that we've got a situation where we dialogue. We've got government, we've got the trade unions from time to time, and the employers to sit down and talk about mining, because for us, mining matters.